Hello class 5, welcome to your online science class. I think you all are doing well and you all are safe. You, as you know, that you have already finished unit 2 syllabus, and today we will start with our pre-annual syllabus, and the first chapter is moon. So please open the page 100 of your book. And as you know that moon is a satellite of our earth, and it do not have its own light, isn't it? And it has been lightened up with the reflection of the sun. So today in this chapter we will learn all details about moon. The moon is a ball of rock, you know, pieces of stone, yes, about one quarter the size of the earth. So one quarter means one fourth of the size of the earth. So how small it is in comparison to earth, you just think of it. It is about 384,400 kilometer away from the earth and is our nearest neighbor in space. So we know that there are many objects and elements in the solar system. So the nearest neighbor to our earth is the moon. That is why it appears so big from earth, isn't it? When we see the stars and all the other objects which are roaming around in our solar system, we see in comparison to other, we see moon in a bigger size, isn't it? That is because it is very near to our earth. Although the moon is the biggest object in the night sky, it does not give out light of its own. We all know that this reflection of the sun falls on it and we are able to see the moon at night. It reflects the light of the sun. Now let's see what are the conditions of the moon. There is no life on the moon, though now we have found out some features, some characteristics of life over there, but still it is not proved. It does not have any water and its surface is covered with a layer of dust. You know, dust particles. So there is no water and the surface is covered with dust. It has mountains and huge round peaks called craters. You know what is huge round peak? Suppose this is the surface of the moon and small mountain, and they are having a big mouth where we can see volcanic eruptions. You have seen the pictures of volcanoes. So the crater is like, it is called the crater and it is having a big mouth called crater on its surface. The mountain and craters can be seen from the earth through a telescope. So with the help of telescope, we know which shows the thing or a particular object in a bigger size. With the help of that, from earth we can see the moon. There is no atmosphere surrounding the moon. Now this part is very important. Why and what are the difference between earth and moon, we can see over here. There is no atmosphere surrounding the moon. So there is no wind, no cloud or no rain. As there is no atmosphere, so there is no feature of changing the weather, isn't it? There is no heat, no cold, nothing, isn't it? So on the earth, in comparison, on the earth, atmosphere absorbs the part of the sunlight. See, what is the difference basically? First, let me read, then I will explain it in the board. On the earth, the atmosphere absorbs a part of the sunlight, so it does not become very hot during day. But on the moon, as there is no atmosphere, it becomes boiling hot during the day. So what is the first thing it is explaining? Please see. See, suppose this is the earth and this is the moon. Okay. Now, a layer of atmosphere is there, but here there is no atmosphere. So when the sun is on the top, the direct ray is reaching over here. But it is earth and it is moon. Here is atmosphere and here there is no atmosphere. So when the sunlight is reaching to the earth, it is reaching through the layer of the atmosphere And thus, what is happening? The direct heat of the ultraviolet rays or the direct heat of the sun is not reaching to the earth. And the atmosphere is absorbing some part of the temperature or the heat of the sunlight, isn't it? And thus, the in the daytime or in the daytime, the atmosphere is less hot than the moon. Here it is less, here it is more. Now, why here in the moon it is more? Because see, there is no layer of atmosphere, and thus the direct heat of the sun is reaching to the moon, and thus in the daytime it is very, very hot in the on the moon. Do you understand? Am I clear? Once again, I will repeat. Why it in the daytime it is very hot and in the moon and earth is less. See, once again I will repeat. Suppose this is earth and this is moon, and we all know that moon is not having atmosphere, but earth is having one atmosphere around the earth, isn't it? And thus one, when the sun, rays of sun, the ultraviolet rays is falling, it is falling on the earth, passing through this layer of atmosphere. In case of moon, what is happening? The ray and the reflection of the sun is reaching directly on the moon. And thus, in the earth, we can exist, the life can exist. But in the moon, in the daytime, it is so hot that life cannot exist. The extreme heat, the scorching heat of the sun. Do you get it? Okay. Also, so, as there is no atmosphere, it becomes boiling hot during the daytime. So, in the daytime, it becomes boiling hot in the moon. Now, also on the earth, the atmosphere retains heat. What is the meaning of retain? Retain means to hold or to absorb it. Okay. Also, on the earth, the atmosphere retains heat at night. So, it does not become very cold. However, since there is no atmosphere, the moon to retain heat, it is freezing cold in the night. Now, see, in the same thing, what happens? I will show you. Now, as there is one atmospheric layer, we have already seen one atmospheric layer over there. When at the night, we know the sun rays used to be reduced back to reflected back. Okay, in this, the same thing happens. And what is happening when it is night? What is happening? The moon is there. Okay, this is moon. Okay, now what is happening when earth is reflecting back the heat which was absorbed at the daytime? It is passing through this atmospheric layer, and after heating somewhere, what is happening? Some part of the heat is coming back to the earth. Am I clear? What is happening? See, in the daytime, the sun rays is falling through the atmosphere. So, when earth again will release back the heat in the night, because there is no sun, so it is the time of reflecting back the heat which was absorbed by the earth, isn't it? Now, what is happening in the night when it is passing earth, when earth is releasing the heat from the surface? It is passing through the atmospheric layer. And what is happening due to this atmospheric layer? Some heat is again coming back to the atmosphere, to the surface of the earth. Am I clear? What is happening? Please see it very carefully. After the moon rays up in the night, what is happening? The earth starts releasing the heat, and when it is releasing, again it is releasing through the atmospheric layer. But due to the atmospheric layer, some heat is again coming back to the earth, and that is why earth is not chilling cold like moon. But what is happening in case of moon? When it is night in the moon, there is no atmospheric layer, we know. Thus, due to the atmospheric layer, what is happening here? Some heat is coming back, but here there is no scope. So, immediately, very fast, it is releasing the moon. The moon is releasing the heat, and thus it is becoming chilling cold in the moon. Just the reverse happened. What happens in the earth? Just the reverse things happen in the moon. Am I clear? Now, again, once again, I will say that the due to the atmospheric layer, staying of this layer, and here there is, as there is no layer of atmosphere, thus the difference is occurring. Here at the night, when Earth is releasing the heat, some of the heat is again coming back due to the atmospheric layer. And the same thing is not happening for the moon, because there is no atmospheric layer, and directly the heat is being released by the moon, and at the night it is becoming chilling cold. I think it is clear to you. If you shout on the moon, nobody can hear you. This is because sound travels through air, we all know. Suppose I am talking, you are hearing, because between us air, continuous passing of air is there, but in the moon there is no air, no wind, no cloud, isn't it? So thus, in the moon if you shout, no one can hear you. The earth pulls everything down with the gravity, or the force of gravity. That is why anything that is thrown up comes down. When you are throwing it up, it is coming down, isn't it? Why? Because of the gravitational force. But as there is nothing in the moon, the force, the gravitational force is very less. See what happens. The moon also pulls things towards itself. But since it is much smaller than the earth, the force of gravity is less. It is only about 1/6 of the earth. So, just think of it, 1/6 means it is very less than the earth. This means that if you jump 1 meter high on the earth, you can jump 6 meters high on the moon with the same effort. The effort which you are giving to jump 1 meter in the earth, if you give the same effort staying in moon, your height will be near about 6 meters, because the gravitational force is less, and due to a small jump, small effort, you are going a far height, very a bigger height than the earth. In fact, your weight on the moon would only be 1/6 of your weight on the earth, so weight will also be less. Okay, that is for today. Next day we will continue with the next part, how the moon moves. Thank you.